Howdy doody. Size. Nobody cares about size anymore. It's all about knights. Knights in white satin. No, this is A Night to Remember, which actually has its own song. So, yeah, it's got a K in it. So if it's not a medieval knight, I don't know what kind of knight it's going to be. Are there still knights these days and in the early 2000s? Yes. But they're fake knights. You know, you get knighted for being good at acting. Not for holding a sword anymore. Oh, I wonder if people who, like fencers, or people who, there's no sword fighting in the Olympics or anything like that. I wonder what the closest thing these days to an actual knight would be. Who gets made an actual knight? Anyway, I don't know what I'm talking about. Last time we took care of the lingering Piper Page problem. And we fixed it. And we're all happy family again. So this will be the first mission where there's nobody's going to mention Prue at all. I think we've mentioned her in every episode so far. But we'll see. Last time Leo was... You see him floating? Doing orby stuff? It reminds me of the part in season one where Phoebe finds out he's magical because he's floating, changing a light bulb. Am I imagining somebody in shining armor? Am I imagining somebody with a sword? Yeah. Are we going to get that? It's going to take some doing. But we might.
Once upon a time, there lived a handsome prince who was about to marry a beautiful maiden. But an evil enchantress with dark powers wanted the prince for herself.
I hate her.
Really?
She's not babysitting.
I was kind of related to her.
Then what happened?
Well, the evil enchantress had to wait for a sign that her powers were at their darkest. See in the stars? See the prince, his sword, and the three stars that form his crown?
Oh, I do.
Well, once the evil enchantress saw the sign, she locked away the beautiful maiden and cast a spell on the unsuspecting prince. Bring together my prince and me. Let him fall on...
I just realized I wasn't listening to her story, and it's going to be important because it's going to be integral to the actual episode. Also, that's not a real constellation. But I did see it. I'm going to go back and listen. Just so I'm up on the lore before the episode starts. Okay, I got it. It's about this enchantress who wants the kingdom and power for herself, so she wants the prince to herself, so she waits till her powers are at their darkest and then casts a spell on the prince or the knight or somebody. And we're in the middle of the spell at the moment. And Paige apparently identifies with the enchantress.
Bended knee. I summon...
The power of three.
I can never remember the end of it.
Let me guess. The prince defeats the evil enchantress. He married the beautiful maiden and they lived happily ever after, right?
Nope.
The evil enchantress bore an heir, killed a prince, and ruled the kingdom forever.
Ooh, dark.
I told you I was a weird kid.
I need to get you out more, Paige.
It'd be easier if you were around more, Glenn.
Around now.
Well, we're totally going back to reenact this story that stayed with her. In we go. Nice.
Summon me. Forgive me for inconveniencing you at this late hour. I had no other choice. Stars have aligned.
You don't frighten me, Enchantress. Tomorrow my prince and I will marry, and there is nothing that you can do to stop that.
Just watch this.
Why are you doing this?
There she is.
because this is my destiny, not yours.
Oh, Charlie. I know that name. Ah, 6 episodes in a row. Are we sorting through her stuff? Oh, I just want to give Piper a hug.
We can't keep living with no electricity. It's medieval.
No electricity.
So we have to figure out when the shocker demon's gonna attack next and fast.
The what demon?
We need the power of 3 to vanquish him, and number 3 lives across town. I am going to call her. Not the cordless!
Ooh, what the? An electricity demon. They must spend so much money just repairing everything.
We have to call Paige and set up a time where she can come over and.
Yeah.
I suggest that maybe Paige move in with us.
That's why she's clearing out Prue's room.
And what if we don't get along?
We didn't always get along with Prue either.
I still half expect to see her walk through the door.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just too soon. And there's only one way to find out.
Oh my god, it's 9 o'clock. I'm so screwed.
Get out of here, dude. It's 9 o'clock.
So I'm leaving tomorrow.
You're always leaving tomorrow, Glenn. That's what you do.
Yeah, Glenn. I love this. I love this on the back of her bed.
9 to 5 isn't you, Paige. You've always had two adventurers of spirit.
Come to Australia with me, Paige.
Australia?
Why not?
Because I've got too many responsibilities.
You're 25 years old.
Oh, she's pretty
young.
You've
got the rest of your life ahead of you for that kind of crap. Come have fun with me.
It's not just my job.
Yeah, dude.
I've got sisters now and stuff we've got to do.
What stuff?
Stuff that keeps me pinned down.
Hey, what's the deal? What's the deal in the past? In the medieval times? How does this that factor into anything?
Is she home?
Yeah, she's home. She's just a little indisposed at the moment.
Yeah, there's a guy.
Sorry to interrupt!
We're not looking!
Baby!
What? I know this looks bad, but it's very important, believe me. Whoa.
Who are they?
The soon-to-be ex-sisters I was telling you about.
That news tomorrow.
See you, Glenn. He's going to Australia.
Plane? What plane? Never mind. So have you been attacked by the shocker demon yet?
No, she hasn't.
You've been watching me?
Well, I didn't see anything.
That's it. Ow! but we need to talk to you about the shocker demon because...
We can't vanquish them without the power of 3.
And not at the manor, so ever.
We need your help.
I think that went fairly well.
It wasn't a good time.
Unbelievable.
What have you done to my beloved?
You mean I'm not your beloved?
Your dark magic doesn't scare me, Enchantress.
Who is he? Who is that guy? Is that the name I recognize at the start that I've forgotten about? Who is that guy? He's the prince, obviously. Is Paige in, is this, I was going to say, is she a descendant of this? This sorceress, but I gotta quickly look up who this guy is. Oh yeah. Yeah. He's in Buffy. I'm not gonna spoil it by saying what character he plays, but he's in Buffy. But yeah, how does this story in the past have anything to do with anything? Is it gonna factor into something in the real world? In the future? Or is it just a nice, funny side adventure? And are any of the people we know from the present also back here? Playing other characters?
Your beloved is right here, my prince.
She's casting a spell on him.
I am forever yours.
As will be your kingdom, once I conceive an heir.
You don't have... Oh yeah, she has to have a baby. Who will grow up to have be and be in Paige's family tree, maybe?
All right, calm down.
But that's also our family tree, sort of.
At least I'm not. Oh.
Do you think because she's the youngest one, Paige, she gets to dress, have the most sort of colourful clothes. I don't know, just this one in particular, it stands out, it's very bright. It reminds me of what Phoebe used to wear when she was the youngest. Maybe it's just this one episode, that maybe it doesn't mean anything, but it just stands out because Phoebe and Piper are very modestly, like they're in black and white basically, and she's super, super bright and colourful. Anyway, you moving in, Paige? We need you to help us with this shock demon, and I thought they were saying chakra, but I think it's shocker because it's electricity. And then move in to Prue's room, and you can spruce it up and make it all green and whatever you want to do with it.
We were sorry.
Yeah, right.
What do you think about moving in with us?
Excuse me? Live together, because that's when we're the strongest.
Yeah, power three.
Are you two out of your freaking minds?
You don't. No. She likes her privacy.
So you're not even going to consider this?
Nope.
If you lived here, you could look at it all the time.
She could just throw it out the window.
I don't want being a witch to take over my life. It's just too much responsibility.
She's only 20-something.
If you're looking for the chakra demon spell, we already found it.
I'm not. I'm looking for something else.
Maybe we can help.
Okay, I know it sounds stupid, but when I was little, I invented this horrible little fairy tale and...
She invented it?
Oh my god.
Oh.
The evil enchantress?
Yeah. She's in the book. No picture,
wow,
though.
I can't believe it. Bring together my prince and me, let him fall and...
Don't say it.
Finally got to finish it.
Oh, here he comes. Into the future.
No!
Hey, prince dude. Welcome to... the future?
My love.
Why do you run from me?
Why are you chasing me?
Because we are meant to be together.
You guys want some privacy?
This is not funny.
Where are you going?
I can't handle this.
Look, you can't keep running away from these things. That's what we're trying to tell you. Being a witch is not a part-time job.
Yeah, well, if I don't leave now, I'm not going to have a full-time job.
The charmed ones come first.
The charmed ones come first.
It always worked when Prue said
it. Is he still frozen? Or has he left the house?
He's gone?
Damn it.
But did he go back to Fairytale Land?
I don't think so. He went out the back way. We never see the back way.
He's just wandering around in chainmail?
It's San Francisco. Nobody will notice.
He's gonna take on this garbage truck.
I don't have time for this.
Oh shit, dude.
What is this metallic beast? You will use it to take me to my beloved. Questions?
I have one. What makes you think he'll return?
I don't. That's why I plan on following his
footsteps. Oh, she's coming.
And bringing him back.
I am the object of his true love.
Sticker.
Your spell only appropriated it. Kill me, and you break the spell.
Ah, screw it.
I know.
Oh, a lock of your hair.
That's why I needed this.
You cannot do this.
Nobody tells me what to do.
Nobody tells me what to do, Leo. God, I've just had enough.
This is who you are. You know that. Why are you running from it?
Oh, gee, I don't know. Being hunted by the Source, ducking the Furies. I don't know why I wouldn't want the rest of my life to be just like that.
You have sisters now.
Yeah, sisters who are pressuring me to move in with them for all the wrong reasons.
I know what she's talking... Well, I know a little bit of what she's talking about. You know, the reasons they gave her were, hey, you know, it's better to... We're stronger when you're around because power of three and... You know, the demons, we gotta fight the demons and it's better if we're all together. It's not, hey Paige, you're our sister, we'd like to know you a bit better, we'd like... You know, we're happy to see you, we want you to move in, because say, sisters and love and bond and all that stuff. That's what she's saying. Well, everybody knows that's what she's saying. I don't know why I posted.
Nothing. Forget about it.
Except for Leo.
And it's a pretty tough act to follow. Don't make me go back there, Leo. Not just yet.
I'll call you if I need you.
Ooh. The Nightman?
Daryl!
A garbage truck? At Sword Point. Please don't tell me that the police found him.
Not yet. Where's Paige?
She didn't want to come.
I don't understand. We're her sisters.
Yeah, but that's not the reason you need her.
Is there more to that, or are you just going to leave us hanging?
This is between you guys.
Leo gets it.
But I will tell you that just wanting her to battle demons with you isn't enough of a reason to get her to move in.
He really gets it. Oh no, he's here.
At last, I found you.
It's been 2 hours, dude.
I followed your heart, my love.
You need to leave right now before security comes.
I will not leave until you are with child.
Okay.
What?
Just keep that sword of yours sheathed, pal.
Oh, the chakra demon. Nice.
Hey, you are right there.
I will stay forever by your side.
Hey!
Oh, security.
What the hell is going on? Who is this guy?
Renaissance fair. See ya.
I don't see what the big deal is. You'd think she'd want to move in here considering the dump she lives in.
What?
Piper.
Hey, can we talk for a second about that dump that Paige lives in? Jeez, the 2000s. They had high expectations, didn't they? She's 20-something, and she has a beautiful room. You know? A lot of space. Maybe it's just the one room, or maybe there's like a bathroom off from it. Hey, it's much better than... Hey, ooh, let's talk about it. Remember Cole? Hotshot lawyer? Dude? His place was tiny. Paige's place is huge. As far as I could see. Piper just called it a dump. Anyway. Yeah, we need to embrace her as a sister. I'm surprised the book even triquetered them until they accepted each other as sisters. After the last episode with the P3 thing coming back together, I thought maybe, you know, we were all good, but we still need to be, I guess we gotta be living together. Until we're all good. We gotta know each other's habits, you know. Take turns in the bathroom, that sort of thing. Don't walk in on each other, that sort of thing. That'll be fine. But, Paige, rent free. You get to move in here. Not too shabby.
Defiant, clever, and independent. That kind of describes Paige, don't you think?
Yeah.
The Enchantress?
I'm telling you, this is Paige. Okay, what if it's not a fairy tale? What if it's a memory?
What?
Paige's memory from a past life.
Oh, past lives. I forgot those were things.
Man, my past life came back to bite me on the butt.
Yeah, forgot all about that. Here she comes.
This doesn't look good.
Oh, the whole place is going to be on fire. Oh, that's going to set everything ablaze. The dollhouse? Yeah.
I got it!
It's not like we're having enough problems with Paige. We have to deal with her past life, too.
Hey, Leo, buddy.
Okay, I found out about the prince.
Paige's past life almost killed us.
Okay, well, you have to stop her. You can't let her find him. If she conceives his heir... Dark magic will rule his kingdom forever. History will be rewritten.
We'll be screwed. The world will plunge into darkness. Yada, yada.
Wait. Isn't the story that she does conceive his... Like, she has his child, kills him, and rules the kingdom? Isn't that what originally... Isn't that the story that Paige knows? So that's the original timeline, right? But we gotta stop that from happening? Okay. We gotta change it. We gotta change the... Maybe the fairy tale is just the Paige's original ending to the story. But how is Paige gonna feel about past life Paige getting obliterated? Maybe we can reason with the Enchantress. Or maybe she's not so bad. Or maybe Paige will do it herself.
So, if we vanquish past Paige, don't we risk vanquishing our Paige too?
Possibly.
We'll bind her powers and send her back in time, hopefully a virgin.
What lures you to this time, my prince?
Paige?
And
what are you still doing here so late? But you left already.
I'm our boss.
Don't tell me you're in the fear too.
You know?
Don't forget to lock up.
Oh, she has the keys to the whole place. That's cool. Oh, she gonna see herself. There she is.
Looking forward to meeting you, Paige.
I still can't believe that you exist.
Was she looking at the stars?
I always wanted to save you from the evil enchantress so you could live happily ever after.
Come with me. Live in my castle as my princess.
What is it with everyone wanting me to move in with them?
Yeah.
Just tell me what you want and I'll give it to you, I swear.
He's coming on strong.
Can you make me as good as Prue was? Never mind, you wouldn't understand.
Whoops.
Well, something's come up. Something you're not gonna like.
The evil enchantress is here.
Oh my god. Actually, that's not the worst part.
She's you.
She's you. And that's also why you remember the fairy tale so well.
Okay. I can deal with this.
Just a normal day.
Does this mean I'm evil?
Yeah.
No.
No. The plan is to bind the enchantress's powers with this little potion.
I'll do it.
Yeah, if that's what you want, we'll be here with the prince.
Okay. Oh, our car. Cool car. I love this car. It's a funny little shape in it. It's got a nice color. Whoa. Could she throw the thing at her?
Don't tell me I become good in the future.
Damn good.
Oh. She needs help.
And here I was so looking forward to meeting myself.
Yeah, but the Enchantress can't kill Paige. Otherwise, she'd be killing her future soul.
Paige is in trouble.
Maybe she could.
Evil Enchantress. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Her old apartment's going to... She doesn't have a fire extinguisher. Put out the fires.
What have I done?
Hey Leo, can the elders open a portal for us? And also give us a fire extinguisher? Thanks.
We need to get them back.
Get them back? What do we do? Hop on a bus to medieval times?
That's a wall, Leo.
You still have that power inside of you. Don't be afraid to tap into it now.
Open a portal. This is way too much power if she can just open a time portal.
Bring together my prince and me, his kingdom now I wish to see.
She's quick with the rhyming.
Come on, I'm not doing this by myself.
Oh, are you still glad you told Paige to go for it? Hey, you were the one that wanted us to be more sisterly.
This is like the previous episode with the...
Okay, find Phoebe and Piper. Jeez. I'll try to hold her off until they get here.
Better do it quick. He's unsheathing his sword.
Yeah. Oh, easy, easy. Behind her!
This is when we need Cole. He's been practicing with his swords.
Hi, I hate to interrupt myself at a time like this.
Headbutts. Yeah.
Leo?
Yeah.
I thought you were a pacifist.
I didn't kill him, did I?
I didn't tell you, I find this side of you very sexy.
Don't hurt her.
Oh, don't hurt him. You need him. Oh, nice.
Now!
We've bound your powers, Enchantress.
How could you do this to me? To us? I didn't do it. We did it.
Oh, this one. Well, happily ever after. I don't care about this one. Can we go back to the future now?
Okay, so I won't be getting my security deposit back. Too bad you don't have any other place to stay. I wouldn't have to stay in the basement, would I?
No, of course not.
No, that's a workout studio
now.
I
think we have a room for you.
I want to see what she does with it, you know? Look, she's done stuff with it already.
Ta-da!
I like her hat.
What do you think?
It's definitely you.
Is that a good thing?
Of course it's a good thing. Oh, I hope that's not another one of your past lives.
Just Glenn, I asked him to drop by.
Oh, the cute guy from the apartment?
He's going to Australia.
Yes, but he's gonna have to be yummy in Australia. He's leaving.
Oh, you disappointed?
A little. But it's not like I'll be lacking in adventures here.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, shall we?
Hit it!
Oh, get him. Well, that was easy.
Piece of cake. Gotta go. And don't forget, if you need me, please knock.
And they lived happily ever
after.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Hey, show. You don't get to have Daryl without having Daryl. You can't just call Daryl. You can't just be pretending to call Daryl on your phone. No, no, no. That don't count. You know, it'd be a bit like Phoebe saying, yeah, I just talked to Cole and he told us that the best way to deal with a electricity demon is... No, you don't just get to say you were talking to Cole. You don't just get to be on the phone to Daryl if you're not in the episode. We want Daryl. He's probably busy just taking care of Cortez. Making sure he doesn't blab. So, I'm going to be skipping around a lot here. Paige's boss, he's the only one that she works with that's a recurring character. Everybody else she works with, there'll be a rotating cast, you know? You know, the shy one who got his confidence, the overly confident one who got his comeuppance, that girl dressed for going out. Now the guards in this episode. It's funny, actually. I kind of want every episode to have her work there, just to see all the different extras they put in. Now, there is one thing I wanted to check. Yeah, I was just checking back on the start of the episode with the how Paige was telling the story about the Enchantress, and in her version, the Enchantress won and ruled the kingdoms. Which is strange, because if that's her past life, that's not what happened. It all makes sense. I know you can't use stories and memories and all that sort of thing, but oh, what am I talking about? Had Paige's version of the story actually been the case, actually come true, then it would have completely unraveled the entire show and Eva would be ruling the lands forever and ever. So it's a good thing her version was not the one. Actually, Glenn's version is what actually happened. Glenn, super psychic Glenn, who's now going to be in Australia. He's going to be like a fortune teller in Australia. He was right. Paige has moved in to the manor, moved into Prue's room, and she has made it her own. And I knew she was moving from a larger space into a smaller space, so her room looks super, it looks like a bit like mine, super cluttered, because there's literally so much stuff in it. But I like how colourful, and I don't want to use the word quirky, but it's, I don't know, there's a lot of unique, there's a lot of interesting stuff when it comes to Paige and what she surrounds herself with. You know, it's very vibrant, it's very there's a certain style to it that I like. You know, if we continue to see more of that, I'll be pouring over, I'll be freeze framing and looking at all the stuff, and you know, whereas Piper and Phoebe's rooms, whilst nice, are sort of generic, sort of interchangeable in a way, you know, they don't really pop so far anyway. Actually, we haven't seen much of their rooms, to be fair, over the 3 years, and Piper and Leo hopped around a bit. So I'm not really sure of the interior of their home or the upstairs or anything like that. In my mind's eye, downstairs, I got it. I know where every room in the downstairs is. Upstairs, once they go up that stairs, it may as well just be the attic, you know? When they go up the stairs, oh, they're going up to the attic. But there's a whole floor up there that I assume is as big as the downstairs area, which is massive. But whose layout is a mystery to me. Because we're never actually in the hallway upstairs. Right? Maybe once? I'm trying to imagine it, you know? Yeah, I just had this memory. I was like, remember that episode where with Billy and they were all running around the house? And I was like, I'm pretty sure they were on the top floor at some point during that. Yeah, they were, just for a small little tiny bit. But we don't get to see it much. So that's kind of fun. I'm not sure they have. They've clearly built the downstairs set. But I think upstairs, they only build the bedrooms when they need them. And it doesn't actually exist as a set, you know? Actually, I'm imagining the downstairs as... I don't know what I'm imagining, really. Like there's no above. You know what I mean by that? Like you can set lighting and cameras up high and there's much more space than we think there is, you know? But I could be wrong about that too. But that would make sense. Like, that would be why. Like, I know they don't film in that house. The house that we see the exterior of. I know they don't film there, but... Yeah. My thinking is that stairs that they run up, that goes nowhere. There's nothing up there. You know? Until they need it for something. Anyway... That constellation, that was pretty, have you ever seen a constellation like that? Pretty detailed. It really stands out in the night sky. And that night, he was so bland, wasn't he? He was a very one note. Actually, so was the princess. Both of them, I guess they deserve their happy ending. Because they're a little like a fairy tale. You know, this episode is a mixture of the fairy tale and the real. It being Paige's imagination, and maybe she just brought the story to life, sort of makes more sense than the actual canon of, no, these people actually existed, and this is what actually happened. Because there's a certain unreal quality to the knight and the princess. And the castle, even, and the massive size of the moon. You know? It all had a very storybook, deliberately storybook feel to it. But really, what this episode was about was sisters and accepting Paige as a sister into their home. Now, did we have to burn down her lovely apartment that she was renting in order for her to move? Yeah. Did the shock demon thing? That seemed like an extra added little niggle to the episode. They came out of nowhere, no build up to it, no lore behind it, and then just kind of disappeared when we vanquished it. Just more incentive. It was to give Piper and Phoebe a reason to want Paige to move in as quickly as possible. And then also set up the dynamic of Paige not feeling like they want her to move in for the right reasons. And then Leo's all in the middle. It's actually a very complicated episode in that way. And a very goofy episode in a different way. But at the end of the day, she's in the house. And I like that. Because now we can have breakfast together. And we don't have to keep swapping between locations to see all the people. We're going to have more scenes with the three of them. Leo's not hopping about the place, you know? Leo's had so much work to do this season, hasn't he? And not only as White Lighter, but also as intermediary, and also sort of kind of a mentor to the White Lighter part of Paige, you know? And Cole is gone. He's just still running from demons. I want him to be in it more, and I want Daryl to be in it more. Daryl's feeling a bit ridden out at the moment. And yeah, that's it. And I want a new bad person, or I want the source to, I want that woman back with her crystal ball. What more action and all that stuff. And I think finally, now that we're all together in the house, we'll get into a bit of a routine. This has been the transition period, and I feel like I'm saying this every episode. I'm like, now we're gonna finally, Piper has brought muffins to Paige, we're all good now. Ooh, we've put P3 back together, we're all good now. Paige has moved into the house, we're all good now. So who knows? The next episode is called Brain Drain. Oh, and the one after is called Black as Coal. Black as Coal. No. Spelled C-O-L-E. So we know it's to do with him. So at least we know he'll be in that episode. Brain Drain. I think I've had that today because my thoughts have been very scattershot. My brain isn't working at full capacity, or maybe it's over capacity. You know? Anyway, I apologize if my outro was more annoying than normal. But we'll fix that for next time. I'll drain my brain and we'll be fine. So, yeah, that was a night to remember. It was on November 1st. Not really Halloween-y, but Paige did get to, or Rose did get to dress up a bit. And yeah, I will see you next time.